Okay, so you're the best catching up. Gold is somehow really potato, but hope it's going well. I have had like, well, technical difficulties like to haunt my streams. And I had a plan to do like pyrography stream, but my burner tip is like broken. So I can't do pyrography anymore. I need to buy a new machine. Which has been like my to-do list for a long time now, but I need to upgrade it. So I'm, well, drawing. I'm sketching to my sketchbook. Because I have had this goal to fill like 12 sketchbook in a year. And it's been like 2 years and I have been failing it on both years. Last year I failed it even more than first time, so I'm hopefully, well, doing it this year again. And for that I need to like work into my sketchbook. And I haven't been like sketching that much. Yeah, this is my newest fountain. I have the review video was up yesterday, so it's maybe not the best color of the sketch because it's like Robert Oster Sublime, so it's like neon green, so it's probably not showing not that well on the video. Reference photo in front of me, I'm using Pixabay, and first I think I will draw some portraits and then I will maybe thinking about what I will do next. Because I feel like I need to like warm up, and drawing portraits from reference is something that I can pretty easily do. Sometimes too easily because I start to like guessing the features and not looking the reference photo, like in this case. And when I'm doing portraits, I often use the Loomis method to like get the basic contrasting of the head, and it really helps to get the head like in right proportions. And yeah, I'm like drawing with the pen because I find it's the fastest way to improve, because then I can't like erase my mistakes, and I, well, every mistake is like really obvious when it's done with the pen. And I also don't like drawing with graphite pencils, they smudge like way too much. And I don't want my sketchbook to turn like pile of pencil mess, like they, I don't know, it's this paper is really smooth, so it doesn't hold graphite that well. And I drew eye way too big. And if you hear some background sounds, that's probably Ruka. Ruka is like sleeping on the floor. Oh, hi Lee! Yeah, happy new year. And for me, I like, I had, this year I made some, not like resolutions, I like to call them goals because it sounds more like serious thing. So I decided I will continue my YouTube channel, and my goal is to get monetizing for my channel this year. And I hope I can do it. I'm not sure it will be possible, but I try. I used to have YouTube monetizing on my channel when the requirements were not so strict, but then they changed them up and I lost the monetizing and haven't been able to make it. It's so funny that this reference photo I'm using is clearly like female, and when I ended up drawing it, it's turn out to be like male, which is clear sign that I didn't pay enough attention to my reference photo. So it's not like if you want to do like portraits or something like pet portraits, I think it's really important to like draw exactly the reference shot and not like drifting too much away from it. But I have a bad habit to like really go away from reference photo. That's why I don't do commissions. And I love this ink, this is like super nice green ink. And I got this as Christmas present. And I have been using it like... I actually have two pens inked with this ink now. Hi Robin. Yeah, this is Robert Oyster Sublime. And I really like this one. It's like nice and bright and it's still saturated enough to be like readable if it's like brighted. Because some inks are so bright that they are not like usable. In not even drawing because they don't want like show up enough, but this is like nice medium. And this is like currently my favorite inks. I actually like most of my inks are this yellowish green tone, but this one has been my favorite now. And also this pen is like, it's so fluorescent. Ah! Yeah, Phantom is really like, they take some time to like learn, because I remember when I started to sketching, I find that Phantom pens were like, I liked ballpoint pens more, because ballpoint pens you can like draw lighter lines, but with the Phantom pens they often do just like really like noticeable line. So it takes some time to like getting used to fountain pens, especially in the sketching. But you can get lighter lines with the fountain pens. I find that like the speed is one thing that determines the line, because if you draw fast enough the lines will be lighter, but if you go slowly the lines are like different. And of course my camera isn't picking that up, but it's like there's some possibilities to like do some line variation. And of course some nips flexes, but this one is not flex nip, it's steel nip, so it's like it's really not flexing. Also it helps if you start like sketching with the lighter color and then change to pen that have like darker ink, so then the first lines are looking much lighter and there's some possible for like doing corrections and stuff. I can show that actually too if I do the next sketch, which like start with the lighter color and then go to draw darker ink. And if you want like neater sketches, then it's like easy to have like pencil sketch underneath and then sketch over that with fountain pen. Because sometimes the guidelines like really bothers. Like I made it here like line is too obvious. I would want to it be much, much lighter. And I'm often really lazy with the shading. I just like do some block shadows or some kind of really loose cross hatching. But I find it needs like some shading so it's not looking so flat. Yeah, I like to use fountain pens for sketching. Actually, I can try and use different fountain pen for each sketch because I have like most of my fountain pens are, I think all my fountain pens are currently inked, and I have like huge pile of them like right next to me. So this was pen BBS, and I'm actually going to write the pen name here. It's pen BBS 309, and the ink was Robert Oster Sublime, which I love. It's great ink. And for the next one, I have too many options. I think I will go with the what will be next on my channel. This is Moonman, another Chinese fountain pen that is not so expensive. This cost like 10 euros, it's eyedropper, so ink is like on the barrel. Like really nice thing to like see the ink sloshing around. And this has extra fine nib, and the ink is... I don't remember what the ink is. I have to think a little bit. I think it was one of those from In Experiment. Sorry, I had to zoom in my reference photo because it's so tiny. Oh, Jinhao's shark pens. I was looking those because they have lovely green version, but I just didn't buy it. I think I'm probably getting it soon. And Noodler's inks are... I actually don't know how they behave, but the problem is they are really hard to get here in Europe, so I don't have any Noodler's ink. So I have not tested those. But I'm planning to get one because Noodler's has that really nice grey... what's it called? Lawrence grey. And I'm planning to get that one, probably. Yeah, Jinhao's are like, they are pretty cheap pens. I would like to try them. I don't have any Jinhao's. All my Chinese pens are like brandless, or then they are pen BBS or Moonman. I don't have that many Chinese pens. I noticed I did here same thing that I usually do when I'm sketching. Like, I watch the reference photo, and then I see that like the head is tilted, but when I draw it, I tilt it like too much. It's like way off. Hope this turns out well. I have a feeling that it may not because. And I feel it's like still the head isn't like my strong point or any kind of tilting. Yeah, it's not. I'm going to turn the paper so it's like straight. Also that funny thing that I'm much better to draw faces pointing to that direction than on the right side. I think there's something to do with them right-handed, but it's really annoying. I noticed when I was flipping to my previous sketchbook that all the faces were like facing the same way. Yeah, that isn't going to turn out well. I don't know why, but I think head is too big and feathers are too small and they are too close to the center and each other. Yeah. And jaw is way too big. Like way too masculine. Definitely will be male. Yep. But I actually, on the new year, I made like, it's not like resolution, it's more like a challenge. I challenged myself to not buy anything on January, like anything that is not necessary, which means like anything that isn't food. So, or anything that is like, I can like live without and not need like immediately action. So in January, I'm definitely not buying any new fountains. Because I find I'm quite like minimalistic in my nature. I don't like accumulating stuff, and in Finland they are, I'm not sure if it's the same tradition everywhere else, but in Finland we have this Tipaton Tammikuu, which means like dropless January. Which is really common thing to have, and it's like no alcohol on January, and it's quite popular thing. So, but I don't drink at all, so I don't find it necessary to me. So I decided I will do like, yeah, I will try like no spend January. Like, it's interesting to try, because I have been shopping quite much, so I want to try how it goes without shopping. And first I will be just at January, but I'm pretty sure it will be, I will be extending it to other months as well. Because I actually want to like get some savings and stuff. Because currently I'm working, and I noticed that when I have more money to use, I just then like start to spend it more. So it's a good way to start some no spending challenge, which sadly means no new fountains. Because they aren't like necessary. I have so many fountains. Oh, it's so cute. Like my, he's not puppy anymore, he's my dog. He's like sleeping on the floor right next to me. I'm really bad at front view. Yeah, it looks. This one was, the pen was Moonman. M2, and ink is, it's Roran and Klinger. I'm just writing R at K because I have no idea how it's right. And I think the color is Verdura. I'm hoping it's that ink. And this is actually one of my new favorite fountain pens. And it's one of my newest one. Well, second newest one. It's so nice to use. It's like eyedropper, and it has extra fine nib. And only thing that bothers me, I will have full review coming out. But only thing that bothers me is this cap feels really cheap. Other than that, pen is great. And also, this tends to like roll because it has no clip or any roll stopping. Next, I think, I'll try to fit something here, because I like when there's like three sketches on the page. I somehow find it like it's more appealing to eye to have three there, like, than have two here and an empty space. The next fountain pen, I know this small space, so I want something with fine nib. Yeah, that takes my Eco, and this is Eco, it's a regular Eco, old limited edition with this nice green color, and this has custom needle point nib, so it's like really, really super fine. So this is like great if you are doing small sketches, And I personally like using extra fine nibs. And finer the better. If there's available something like ultra extra fine, like platinum, has that's the nib I will choose. Like finer the nib, the better. I just like super fine nib. They are like they are nicer when sketching because you can do more lines and the lines you like chose to be right. You can like enforce them by going over a bit more. But I have some broad nibs also, and I may be using those as well. This goes a bit better. It's a bit easier, like in terms of. I drew that line like way too crooked. I'm really sorry if I'm like rotating my page so oddly because. I have really specific angles what I want to do, like drawing arches. So I often turn my page, sketchbook in this case. This is a needle point, it's like really nice to draw, but it's like because it's so fine nibs tend to be really scratchy, so this one is not smooth at all. It's like really it's like it can make hole to the paper if it's get pressure too much. It's like it need to be like really light hand. So I think it's like needle points are not needed for beginners. Because in wrong hands these may break or stick to the paper and feel really awful. You have to like have to have like really light hand to be able to use this. And getting even something out here because any pressure makes them feel worse and they are not smooth nip to begin with. Trying new, like different thing to have like more pronounced shading. Because I accidentally draw eyes so dark that I feel that they need to be like counterblended. My mic is not picking too much the scratching sound this nip makes. It's not like it's really scratching it because it's so fine. But this is great if you have like small handwriting and then to write like really tight spaces, so it's like it makes so fine line that it's easier to use if you have like fill some forms or something. And also it works great on not so good paper because it's so thin line, it can spread it around a little bit and still be legible. Eyes need some color. They look creepy if they're like leaving. another eye is like pointing way off. Well, close enough. But then extra fine nibs are really annoying, and needle ones, if you have like color or something, you have like color go there like million times to make solid color. And so this nib is really dry, it's like properties of the extra fine. Extra fines and needle points a bit dry side. And this was Wispy Eco, and ink was Pelican Edelstein Amethyst. I have a hard time remember what ink I have on which pen because I don't keep track of that. Like, I give it some way, like, I often write on my, like, Rodian notepad and, like, my sketchbook, the pen and the ink, and I know if I find that note, but sometimes I don't mark it anywhere. So I have a hard time to know which ink is in which pen. I think I really need to start to, like, marking them down and keeping track of that, because I have some cases where ink has caused some problems, and then I have, like, no idea what ink was in the pen in the first place. So then it's like a bit, well, hard to find the which ink is causing problems. If I can't even tell what ink was it was in the first place. Next. Actually there's also this bit blue tone, so I will grab my other Twispy Eco. And this is Twispy Eco T. And how the difference is that T is triangular shape and regular eco is like hexagonal? No, yeah, hexagonal or something like that. And parallels are round, but gap are also, this has triangular, this has more like angular. And also grip sections are different. But they are really hard to notice because Eco has these clear grip sections, but Eco T has more triangular shape and regular Eco is more rounded. No, that's Eco T. That's it. The colors are quite close together. And this has regular extra fine nib. It's like that Twispy offers. And that was the needle point. Let's hope I can make this work, because this reference photo is much more different than I usually draw. Because there's this quite large hood going. But I find it really interesting because hoods are something I enjoy drawing. They are like, they have form and shape. And they are often quite stiff, so they may have like really interesting 3D form going. And they need to have some form going to look natural and like realistic. And then there's this I forgot the word. The thing you wrap around your scarf. Yeah, scarf. And it's also doing really interesting 3D shapes. Like this oversized scarf. And then there is, well, I think I should draw face too and not like empty head. And face is actually quite front weaven. I like to sketch nose. Feels really loosely, but I like to use this tree, like three, like larger circle on the middle and smaller ones on the side. This area here is covered with the hair, so I'm not bothering it with too much. It's really annoying when the eyes are like not matching in my sketch, and I find this pretty common problem. I've heard that from quite many artists that it's like annoying to draw another eye. Like the other eye. I didn't like the expression the model has in this picture, so not drawing it. It's like regular neutral mouth. Oh. Sorry about that sound. It was like my puppy, like, well, he's not a puppy. Ruka was like turning around and he's now sleeping, like his legs pointing to the sky, and aww, he's looking so cute. Oh, hi Lana. No worries, the beginning was actually because I streamed a bit earlier today than usual, so I think it's not so easy to catch because earlier than usual. And I noticed that I have similar problem when drawing like hair, is that the head is like deformed because it's under the hood in the reference photo. So I need to help that a bit. I'm trying to do the shadow here. Like so. And this photo is actually a really bad reference photo. I noticed it just right now because it's like, it is photoshopped a bit, so it has like really unnatural shadows. That's one thing that I always like gives away, like shadows. They seem like, and actually I think I will quickly snap photo of Ruka, because if you don't know, Ruka has his own Instagram, and yeah, I'm actually not sure will this work out. I could of course move it to my computer, but this is this is how he is sleeping. I think he's so cute. And yeah, his tail is like huge. It's like this huge, like fluffy thing. Oh. I find it really cute that Ruka is like, he's like large dog, and then he has this huge tail that, like, when he like whack his tail, it's like, it's so cute because it's like huge, and it's like long hair, and it's so fluffy. It's cute. I think I need to do shadow here because it's like under the hood, and I have hard time to like differentiate this.
Oh, look, look.
Oh, Ruka is so cute when he's,
now he's like waking up and he's like, Ruka, tule tänne, tule tänne, tule tänne, tule, tule tänne, tule.
Ruka is, well, he's too big to like, to be on the lap now, but... Yeah, Ruka is really funny. I like picked him like halfway up and tried to rotate the webcam, and then Ruka was like, "Nyan, welcome to the kitchen." He's just waking up, so he's a bit like tired. I think he was like trying to sleep, and me speaking here next to him, he's like annoyed. Yeah, it's like, it's... faces are really hard to draw, and I find something about faces and without reference, it's that we have this almost like these symbols in our brain. Like, if you are drawing face, you often think that, like, you draw eyes and you draw them like really symbolic way. And you... It's really interesting. When you start drawing from reference photo, you notice that how much, like, brain thinks... things and like change what we see, and we think we know how the face should look like. We know how it should look like, but when we're trying to draw it from memory, it's like it's not looking right. Right, it's like a really interesting thing I have like learned. And it takes so much like skill to like draw face from memory. And it takes so much practice. I think I can do it at some poses that I have drawn a lot, but oftentimes it just ended up looking not so realistic. I can draw much better if I use like reference photos. It's really hard because there's like hair, and hair is dark, and then the hood is dark. And I have only one dark tone here. I don't have like mid tone or anything, so I have a bit hard time to like make the hair separate from the hood. And then this large fluffy scarf. Yeah, funny. Ruka is like walking away and went to sleep in the kitchen because he was probably really annoyed. It's like trying to sleep and I'm just blabbing here for the computer, and he was like, "Oh, he's so cute." Trying to sleep when I'm trying to stream. Yeah, Lana, I have same thing. When I'm drawing from memory, I have that one default face that I'm getting out. I actually have one really funny example here. Like, oh, I skipped one page. Oh, I need to do that. Like, here. This face. And then It was somewhere. This is looking way similar, but it's on black paper, so it's not showing so well. But if I went to look here, there's the... Was it on this sketchbook or the other one? I think it's on this sketchbook. Yeah, here. The same face. It's just literally like the same face. And it's even the same similar head, like hairstyle. It's like really, really odd, like... I often draw, notice that like when I draw a head and I was like, that's look awfully familiar. And then I like roll the page and notice, yeah, it's the same face I have been drawing before. Where am I drawing? This one. Oh, poses. Yeah, I was like thinking to do goal that I want to learn to draw like full human body, because I really never draw anything else than head. I don't even draw the neck often. But then I was like, nope, I'm too scared of that. But probably I have to do that some point. I have a really good like anatomy book that has been unused for years, because I'm way too scared to start like drawing humans. But noodles are a really great way to like learn, because if you draw just clothes, often they look flat and not that like realistic at all. But I hope that someday I find the courage to start to like drawing full bodies. Probably this year I need to tackle that, but because I now feel that I have not perfect but half decent like portraits, but I need to do like something else than portraits, because I feel I have like, when you get something like decent on some drawing some subject, it takes, I find, more hours to get better, because you already have the basic skills. So I think I will see more improvement if I start to draw like human bodies or animal anatomy or something. And also I feel that with the portraits I often lean too much to my like personal drawing style and not learning so much new. And one scary thing that I need to study is perspective. I hate drawing perspective, but I need to do that. I'm not sure will this scarf look like a scarf or just like a blob of something. Yeah, it maybe looks somewhat like scarf. Yeah, I have seen that channel. I think I need to actually write that down. Ooh, that sounds so cool. Like, I tried to find, because I know there used to be like atelier, like close to, not close to me, but it was like in my town. And I was really looking, is there like this drawing night, but nope, there was nothing. And it's actually close now, so I'm a bit sad. Because it would be so nice to go and draw like human figure from life. And it's a bit hard to find those friends that needs to like, that can like pose for you for like, what is, can take like half an hour or something, and being naked. It's not easy thing to ask for a friend, especially in Finland. I actually like how this was turning out. I was fear it will not be this good, but it turned out nice. And then I will do the same thing with the others and write pen name here. This was Twispy Eco T, and the ink is, I guess it's Diamine Aqua Lagoon.
No hei, tulitko katselemaan? Tuliko katselemaan?
Yeah, Luca came back. He's like
getting some good scratching on his back. Oh.
Huh? He's like watching what I'm doing and sniffing my sketchbook and getting some more petting. I like large dogs because they are like easy to pet. They are so large that you can like go and really like scratch them, and then like dog hair flies everywhere.
Everywhere, dog hair, dog hair.
And I like also, it's nice to pet Ruka because he's so like large dog that I don't need to like bend down or anything. He's like right there. So I need to choose the next fountain pen to travel. I was first thinking that I will travel like with every fountain pen I have inked, but looking all the fountain pens, that's not happening today because Eve's stream will be after this one. So I started earlier, so I have 2 hours time to stream, and then we all can go to watch Eve's stream. I need to choose the pen I want to use. Literally I have, well, just like all my fountain pens laying on my table. Oh, there's one windy one. Oh, it's empty because when, if I have like, I don't know if anybody has like windy fountain pens, but I do, and they're hard to tell if they are empty or full because I don't ink them all. If they are empty, I leave the piston down, so when I see this gap here, so the piston is in down position, I know the pen is empty, so I'm not trying to draw with it. There's my other Twispies and more fountain pens. Bit more fountain pens. Fountain pen and fountain pen, and there's one more. Oh, this one is fountain pen. Like, yeah, I can draw with all of. I can't like do the stream where I draw with all my fountain pens. And I also have a bunch of vintage fountain pens, but they are on the. I think most of them are not inked. I have noticed that I have like way too much fountain pens inked up, and I find that my like fountain pens are just like drying up. Hi Stacy. Yeah, Lammies are great. I have next one could be Lammy. If I try to find the one that had extra fine nib on it. Because I have two Proach, which I use like the glitter inks. And then I have two extra fines. Well, this one. This was Lammy China special edition. It's like Lammy Pikachu. And it came with the Pikachu. And it has tail here. And it came in like really cool like Pokemon ball case, and it was like most awesome thing I have ever bought. I like, it was great. Great buy. It was really expensive, but it was great. I'm sorry, I had like chew my reference photo here. Yep. But this has boringly, I think it has black, Lammy black ink. Yeah, that's my go-to black. And it has extra fine nib, which I find really great because most often when you have like regular, like limited editions, they may have like only medium nibs or something, and this was like extra fine nib only. I don't like, I I don't like when I start to draw like these hairlines in the sketch stage, because I know they are staying there and they are not going to fit to my drawing. And I have been trying to get out of that habit to do like one line multiple times, but that sometimes slips out of my mind. Especially if I'm not like fully focusing on my sketching, I often tend to do that. And there's actually good like practice thing you can do if you have that tendency to draw one line multiple times, is that you look for object, it can be any object, and then you try draw the object. It's not like contour drawing, but it's more like you can draw every line just once, and it takes so much concentration to do that, like really thinking the lines and really just drawing every line just once. And I find it really helpful to like combat those hairy lines, and it's a really effective way too. I think I need to do that practice at some point. And it's need to do with the pen, because you can't erase. You can, but it's like fights the idea. And again, I draw the chin like way too large. That's not nice. I don't know how I started to do that. I think I need to do some Loomis method practice, so I can get the proportions right. This head is looking really wonky right now. It's not like... Can you... I just hate when I start to drawing something and then I notice that the chin is off, like the head is off and everything is tilted and eyes are different size, and it's like... I started getting... Start like in the wrong mindset. When everything is like off. I remember when I was younger, I used to always that trick that the hair goes over the eye, because I feel that I couldn't draw the other eye similar than the other one, because I wasn't using any reference photo and I had like zero practice of drawing, so. Why am I drawing ear if I know what I'm drawing like? I'm really like out of focus right now, like really focusing something else than drawing. The reason why I need to do long hair is because I need to hide this another chin I draw here. Well, it's just looking like horrible. Oh, hi Stefan. Also, it's nice to see people coming to my stream. I was worried because it started a bit earlier than usual that would be like nobody. But I will try now, like for now on, start to streaming on my regular time on Sundays. Because I have like no way to stream any other day. I have too long. Robin, any advice drawing beards? Oh, beards, they are hard to draw. I have not drawn any beard. Now I make an ink mark from my phone. I think I haven't been drawing any. It's it's really hard subject. It's like super hard to cover. I have tried it sometimes, but it's like it ended up looking horrible. It's really like you have to be really mindful to how the hairs grow and they are not straight. They are often like curled a little bit, and how long it should be. It's really hard. I think I don't have any bread actually. And I'm not sure if I try it, will it be success or not? I think not. Yeah, no bread here. But yeah, it's really, really, really hard subject to crowd. And I'm actually writing the pen here. Lamy Safari. And I actually had to write Pikachu here because I have many safaris. And Lamy Black. I think let's try to find. Actually, I keep this one page back because I had. Let's see if I can find reference of beard. Oh my, this is not going end well. Oh, I just tried to like follow the from the Pixabay to find some reference photo. Let's try this one. Let's see how drawing beard go. I'm not anyway like expert on this subject. This is probably first one I'm going to draw. And now I'm thinking I'm taking to my pencil. If I can find it. Nope. Yeah, I can find my pencil. And that was Fountainer dropping on the floor. It's sad because I have only one pencil I like to use on sketching, but. And then when I lost it, I like, oh, it's there. So let's try to draw a beard. It's really hard to draw. That is one thing I know. It's like. And also because the hair is often, like, those beard hairs are often curly, they are not straight, so they need completely different, like, way to approach things. It's a bit crooked here, and now I'm drawing it way too crooked. I'm straightening it. This will be a bit larger sketch than the others and probably a bit more detailed because I'm going with the. It's actually really hard because bread like eats the whole jaw area. That's interesting. Yeah, it makes sense that it's not. It's like hiding the jaw, but I wasn't thinking about it. Let's see how this goes. This can go horribly wrong. I think it will go horribly wrong. I'm first getting some features like nose. I use different meters now because I noticed that this reference photo has a sharper nose, so I use like this V shape and then drawing rest of the nose. Just loosely. Then I don't remember the ears. Eyebrows are going. And then the eyes go somewhere there. I'm so nervous that the prayer will go not so well. Especially I noticed that I a little bit like changed the pose. Well, the head tilt. Yeah. This eye is like way, way too large. I have to find the eraser. And if you don't know, my working table is like huge mess, so that's why everything is like lost. But because now I'm actually drawing with the pencil, I can draw some more guidelines. The nose and the this is going to be harder than I was thought. So I can't even see the mouth here. I'll just know like identification of the mouth, like here. And this aura here is like what is called. Like facial hair. Yeah, Ali, I have similar feeling that this will not turn out well. I try first to go like draw the general shape of the facial hair, like blocking it in or something. And there's actually two like hairless spots, which are pretty common. And then there's the rest of the bread, and it goes all the way there. No one knows that the eyes are looking, that's like horrible. Looking somehow like really psychotic. Yeah, it needs to be smaller. This doesn't look bothering me too much too. Yeah, and it goes there, and there it goes up. And to my savior, this has knit hat, so I don't need to draw the hair. But there's a bit of hair showing off, and it goes all the way there. Somehow I draw this eyes so like not that coherent at all. This eye should be now it's looking something. And I try really careful looking how my reference photo is going. And try not to turn this to like Santa Claus or anything. Oh, it just feels so it's not easy. Oh Robin, no worries, I like challenges. I like to draw hard things because at one point I drew many pages of hats. And men wearing hats because I was noticing that I didn't draw that. I often like don't draw hats, so I was not good at drawing them, so I just had to fill a couple of pages with them, so I enjoy like drawing something that I'm not familiar with. Like general shape going here, and then there's like I can see a bit of the upper lip here. but just a tiny bit. Yeah, Alana, they are like some kind of human fur. I agree. Not easy things to draw. Definitely. I'm trying to do the same with the, like, what I'm doing with the fur is that I try to focus on the edges, like on the silhouette, and it often make it look. And I notice it's quite jagged lines here, so they're like twisting and turning, and they're definitely not smooth. I'm thinking that I have drawn brats before. I don't remember how they succeed. I think they didn't succeed that well. This is a definite job for like pencil because I feel that it will be hard to do it in like one tone. So I'm doing it sometimes with the short hair. I go like the edge and give edge this, in this case, really jacket look, like there's those loose hairs pointing out. And same here. And then I'm slowly going from like outside edges towards the like center. And same like with the hair, that don't draw like every hair. Because I can see in the picture this aura is actually completely black and only part of the hairs are showing. I try to emphasize that. And also a bit like erratic number of the bread hairs. They are like not straight or curly, they are going like every possible direction. And then his mustache are like more coherent, I should say. I don't know the proper terms here. Interesting. Definitely interesting thing to draw. I think I'm giving like face tone for this area. And definitely not drawing every hair. Like same thing goes with animal hair. Draw only the clumps and not like the each individual hair. And then I tried like add some hair here and there and try to make this edge blend with this aura. And this is especially much easier to do with the pencil because you can have like multiple tones. So I think if you draw hair with the pen you have to draw more of those lines. Hi, look. Here you go. Ruka came here like showing good example how to draw fur. How to draw fur. Yeah, and facial hair. Hey. Yeah. And also one thing that I find a bit like important here is that it connects to the face and not like looking like something like clip on. Yes, there's all. I can see in the picture this. Awfully loved toy because it's like a piece of wood and I have hard food. Second, I have to take the toy away from Ruka. Yeah. Ruka has this, like, it's made of bamboo. It's like a chew toy that is made of bamboo and it's tastes like pecan, so, and because it's so hard, because it's made of bamboo, and I have hard wood flooring, it makes horrible sounds. So, for the sake of my hearing and everybody in the stream, I took it away. Where was I? Yeah, there's like these stray hairs of beard. It's really hard word to pronounce. And now Ruka is like running around with his toys and being like, ah, play with me, play with me, play with me. Yep. But yeah, no, that's Ruka has like he doesn't have any squeaky toys because Bun doesn't like the squeaky sound, and that actually drives me crazy too. So he doesn't have any squeaky toys, but I have like hard time when I'm editing videos because sometimes Ruka does something really stupid on the background, like yams really really loud or one thing that really interrupts, which hadn't happened yet on this stream. Is the Bun drinking. Yo, if you have been on my previous stream, you know that sound, and that's often in my videos, and I have to like wait to Bun to stop, then I start saying something, and Bun like starts drinking again, and it's like, it's that clicking sound that you maybe hear at some point. But Bun seems to be sleeping now, so he's not making background sounds on my streams. But yeah, it's much harder to control what. Yeah, Ruka is like way too excited about something now. It's really hard when you are streaming and you have pets to have like silent background. No, it's not happening. And with videos, it's possible because you can edit those out, but with the live streams, it's not possible. Ruka is like running around with his toy and being like hyperactive. He's pretty young still, so he has all the energy.
Hei, Ruka! Ruka! Aina, etkö sä mulle sen lelu?
Joo. And this was what the Ruka was bringing. Ikea rat.
Look, it's a rat.
And there was his snoot.
Yeah. Some good to go war. Yeah.
Like, to go war is something that Ruka likes to play. Other types of playing is not his favorite, but he's like love to tuck toys. yeah, he's like really pulling, and because my like chair has these like wheels, it's like he's pulling me around.
Do you want this? Istu. Ei peruta ku istu. Ei peruta ku istu. Istu. Hyvä.
Yeah, no, I throw him a toy and he's bringing it back. But then he's not bringing it because he's not... Rukas, he has this good intention. He like run after the toy and then brings back to me. But he doesn't want to let go. He's like still holding it. But concept of like fetching is a bit...
Yeah, there's that. Don't, there's fun of this. Yeah.
If I could like now focus to my stream. But yeah, this is basically how I draw the beard. It takes good reference photo and patient. And my friend is like watching Ruka, so you may hear him on the background. Because Ruka is still a bit young, so he sometimes needs to like get outside of do his business, so it's nice to have somebody to take Ruka there, and like I don't need to like stop the stream because of that. And also because Ruka is like, as you can hear, he's like really energetic and he can do some, well, mischievous. Especially if I'm not like watching him, so it's good to have somebody watch over Ruka. Oh, Lana, that's so cute. Like, yeah, Ruka like brings it back, but he's not giving it back. He's like holding it with his teeth and being like, nope, I'm not giving you this one. So I do that the way that I often have two toys that I can throw, and then I throw the first toy and hide the other one behind my back, and when Ruka brings the first toy back, I bring throw the second one. And then he drops the first one in front of me so I can throw it next. It's surprising nice to draw with pencil. See you later, Lee. It's really nice to draw with pencil for a while. I haven't been drawing with pencil not that often. Well, I often do the sketching part, but not like shading, so really nice. Especially because my reference photo is black and white, I find it's like works well. Drawing nose is something I hate. I always find it a bit hard to draw. And I hope you can see my lines because I use aged lead, so it's like hard lead. And it's not showing up that well on paper. But I do that on purpose because softer leads tend to smudge a lot, so I don't like that either. So I use harder leads. And it's rotring 600 in clutch pen format. My previous clutch pen was from Carandage, and I find that font pen lying in the ground, and I really fell out with the clutch pen mechanism, and I have been using clutch pens ever since. Before that I was using mechanical pencils, but I find clutch pen is nice for sketching because tip is like, it's much thicker, it never breaks, and it's not so sharp than regular mechanical pencil, it's sometimes like scratch paper really badly. So this one is more like, feels more like regular pencil. But basically it doesn't need sharpening at all, because if you can start like, if you're sketching something and you can use the blunt point, it's like, it doesn't need that sharpened that often. And it's much easier to shade if you have like really like well rounded point here. I think I need to like, I would want to get some like age lead and a little bit like refine some features, because I feel it's like a bit too like blended out, because my pen is currently really like dull, so but I would actually sharpen this one for doing features a bit better. Also, maybe I could erase this. No, it's from Rotring. Use my camera and pick it up. And actually they have fountain pen version of this Rotring 600, which is like aluminium and trifil, like I can't talk today, and like similar design. It's really pretty, but they don't make it anymore, so it's like has to buy from second hand and it gets really expensive. I have eyeing it for some time on the eBay, but decided it's not worth of the price. But there's the other type of fountain pen, I think it's Levenger, that makes quite similar feeling, which has this which is aluminium and this knurled grip section. So I'm probably getting that one. But yeah, the Rotring 600 fountain pen would be awesome. I'll try to do all the blending before I go and sharpen this pencil, because when I sharpen this one, it's not going to do the blending so well anymore. I think I need to add some highlights to the bread as well, which I always feel that I'm like mispronouncing. But in Finnish, bread is parta. Which I find is really like descriptive word for it. And then the mustaches are viikset. Oh, Rotring fountain pen, are they like reissuing it? I think they don't have it anymore. Like, not the 600 line, but I think they may have like other models coming out. But the Levenger one is like quite close to what the Rotring has. But Levenger one has that like smart, like stylus on the other end, which would be really useful at like at the work or something. But I've been little thinking I don't need to buy new father, but I have like way too much father mess already. So I think I need to do some. Well, really thinking about what father mess I want to buy next. And more precisely, maybe selling some of my father pens. I have so many vintage pens that I never use that it's not fair. It's not like fair, but they're not bringing me any joy. And somebody would definitely want to have some gold nipped vintage pens and give them more use than I have ever given them. So I would like to sell them soon. And I have actually like promised myself to buy 2 fountain pens this year. And one, well, more if there's like limited editions that are green. But the pens I'm going to buy this year are Opus 88. I'm not sure will it be the Picnic or the Coloro, but Opus has really nice fountain pens. I want to try those out. And then another one is probably the Levenger fountain pen, which is the Rotring, like, it's not copy, it's inspired by Rotring. But I don't know, because if you visit some store that is like has really old inventory, there may be some of those still around. But I think they stopped producing it at the 90s or something. Yeah, now I'm going to. No, I'm drawing the other eyebrow first. Yeah, now I'm going to sharpen this up. And this is not the regular sharpener, because you can't like go and sharpen this one in a regular one. Some pens have like sharpener here in the back where you can just like go, but this one hasn't. So I have to have I bought the Staedtler like tube sharpener, which has been really handy. It makes super sharp points, and I like that it's like contains all the lead dust inside. So it's like rounding it. Oh, this makes probably horrible sounds. I'm sorry. Yeah, and then there's like this spongy material that I can use to like getting all the graphite dust out and like fine tune the tip. It's still not sharp. So now I have sharp point here, and I hope I can refine some features here. And I think it makes great difference when you have like graphite drawing that has some crisp lines going to, like, really makes it more realistic and looking less smudgy. Also, it's a great way to make like eyes to pop, make them well look much better. But I always try to leave some not so sharp edges, so it's not starting to look like unrealistic. Like giving it Because if you have all lines are sharp, then there's like nowhere where the I lost my version thought, but if you draw everything really sharply, then there's no like anything variation on the drawing, so it's not looking like it looks like there's like no focus at all. So if you but if you leave some areas not so sharp and some sharpen them up, they make really great contrast together and up there much better drawing than having everything that's like one focus. Because that's how human eyes works too, it's like there's not all the parts are in the focus. And nostrils and there's actually not many places where there's like hard edges. I found those places are great. Like it's often around the eyes and nostrils and anywhere else where there's like hard shadows. And often on the lip area. And I'm probably adding some here as well. So it's not looking so soft, so give it a bit more detail, because I lose some detail when I'm doing the drawing with the pencil, because it's smudge under my hand, so I'm like redefining some lines, but not too much. I don't want it to be, because if I put too much detail and lines here, it will take all the attention. And one that I have learned is that if you have like some area that you are not so good at drawing, try avoid adding too much lines and details there, because if there's too much details and especially if there's contrast, high contrast, the eye will draw on there. So I often try to do the eyes with the most contrast and then other parts with varying contrast. So eyes get all the attention and not other things. I think I can actually clean this even a bit more. Yeah, I'm liking it. It's not the perfect one, but I'm liking it. And then I need to find my Tomboy eraser, because I want to get the highlight in the eye showing up better. It's there. Oh, I don't want the square one. And I also want to find my like the eraser that's on the pen. Ah, it's there. And of course this needs to be sharpened, because it's I have bad habit that if I store my pencils, I store them like dull. I don't never like remember to sharpen them, because it would be nice to have like sharpened up after use, so when I need them next time I have them sharpened already, but I have tendency to then leave them unsharpened and then go every time I need them go to do some sharpening. I'm adding some really subtle highlights here. I'm going to make them a bit smaller with my pencil, like blending them back. And I actually feel that here would be highlight. Because I don't like that when drawing with pencil you like lose the highlights because it smudges so much. Yeah, there is looking back by like going and erasing, but it often draws off the followers a little bit, so. And even with the like sharpest possible eraser, it's not so accurate than the pen, and it starts to be like smudge and erase things that are not meant to be erased. But actually I don't want to like achieve like super sharp highlights because I feel that they doesn't look so natural. I think they're often something that like belongs to the digital art. Because they can make like really whitest white highlights without smudging and really sharp, and I often find they look really unnatural and give away to like it's easy to spot the watches made with digital watches with like traditional art by looking how the highlights go. And so I noticed, yeah, I'm out of camera and I'm sticking my head to the front of the camera. Yeah. That's happens when I'm taught to do like really detailed work. Yeah. I can call it done soon. And some more details here. It's actually got really, really detailed, like, I usually don't do this detailed portrait, but... It's a nice change. So yay, there's the bread and how I draw it. It takes so much patience and draws like animal fur. And I'm like blending this edge here towards the knit hat because I feel it's too making like there's too strong line there. Oh, I have only 20 minutes to go. Yay. Time has been like flying. Like little. I was like ready like it's only 1 hour gone, but yeah, it's only 20 minutes left. My streaming time. I'm liking how this turned out. Yeah. And I know it will smudge a bit on this page, but it's actually good that it's on that page, because like I skipped accidentally these pages, so now next time I draw on this side, so there's a couple of papers between, so it's not like transferring only mids on that side, so this what happens sometimes. Yeah, but I've been drawing fourth page if I do this one too. Yeah, I'm gonna go back to the fountain portraits. I'm trying to find. I like look reference photos beforehand and like open a bunch of them on my tabs, but I try to find something that makes me want to draw. None of them feels great. And also because I use Pixabay, I think there's a limited amount they have portraits there, so I often feel that I have drawn all of these. It may not be the bad thing, because I enjoy when I draw like same, like when I draw from same reference photo and different times, and there's some time passes and I notice that the newer one is much better than the previous one. Yeah, I think I should go on DeviantArt too, because it gets boring to draw same faces all the time. And I have this preference to draw faces that are... Oh, this one looks nice. No, it's not. Yeah, Pixabay has really great like selection of animals, and I'm actually getting animals here too, like there's wolf and ducks and horses, but I'm so bad at drawing animals, like super bad, so I'm not even trying. And this one is looking nice. I need to choose the fountain pen for this one. Let's go with this one. And this is my Lamy. I could say it's vintage Lamy. I don't know how old this pen is, but it's not like new Lamy. I bought it from seller from like Finnish auction site. And this is Lamy Alpine. Like the white body and black clip is Alpine, and the nib is black too. It has basic Lamy blue ink currently inside. It says cartridge, because I don't have a converter on this one. But what is odd here is this symbol. I'm not sure if how well my webcam will focus, but this is, and I had like topic going on Found Open Network, and somebody recognizes this as small German state symbol or seal or something. I don't know how it ended up on the Lamy pen, like Lamy Safari, which is not even expensive pen. It would be make more sense like on Lamy 2000 or something, really iconic pen, but it's on Lamy Safari. I actually noticed this has like medium nib. But I have idea, because this one has medium nib, I think, and this one has extra fine. These both have blue inks. So I try to do sketching by like sketching the guidelines with the extra fine, and then doing the refinement with the medium nib. And it's actually pretty helpful if you want to like get some like something to like some opportunity to like fix your mistakes, because it's easier because then the guidelines are much lighter. Where they aren't lighter, but they are thinner. But I try only to the like the basic guidelines and not like the everything. I'd rather really like look the reference photo. Yeah, if I drop, I hope that the other like eyebrow fixes this expression because it's now looking really funny because there's only one of them. Yeah, it's still looking a bit wonky because eyes are not on the same line. That happens a bit too often. Well. No erasing because it's ink. And now for the medium nib. And I don't have that many medium nibber pens, but as you can see, it's much easier to like color areas with the one solid color. But I still like to use extra fines. I don't like use mediums. I have only like two fountain pens that have medium nibs and two that have broads. And broads are because I needed something for my sparkle inks. And these two mediums are nibs that I haven't been able to choose because this one was vintage one and the other one was I won it from the giveaway, so it was default as medium. So but I haven't actually planning to like regrind my other Kaveco, which has the medium nib, to like Architect or something really like some fun nib, or buy some really cool like custom nib for it. Because currently all my nibs are extra fines. Yeah, it's not a bad thing because I like extra fines, but it gets a bit boring because every fountain has extra fine nib. Some has fine because because extra fine wasn't available as size, so well, my vintage ones has more like medium nibs because that was more common than back then, but yeah, almost all modern fountain pens have extra fines. But this lays down so generous amount of ink. It's not so good, especially here in the neck. Nick's nose is too small, actually. I'm judging how it goes. Yeah. It's a bit too small. I don't like when the reference photos are so like. Some photos because the woman's wear so heavy makeup that it's like impossible to tell his face structure, like it looks so flat because it's make it up that way. And of course my drawing will be looking more flat because there's nothing to found that shape. So hey, there was the lady and this was Lamy Safari. I got Alpine and ink is Lamy Blue because it was cartridge and it's 15. Yeah, EVS stream will be starting up soon, so I think I will grab something to eat and I will go to the EVS stream, and I hope other viewers too go to the EVS stream. I have a link on the video description for the EVE channel, so go there and hope I see you in my other videos, and hope I see you also in Eva chat, because I will be there. Bye.